Hello everyone, this is the question asked in GATE 2021 Computer Science and Engineering Set 1. Given below are two statements 1 and 2 and two conclusions 1 and 2. Statement 1, all bacteria are microorganisms. Statement 2, all pathogens are microorganisms. Conclusion 1, some pathogens are bacteria. Conclusion 2, all pathogens are not bacteria. Based on the above statements and conclusions, which one of the following options is logically correct? So, we have been given with two statements and two conclusions based on those statements, and we have to determine what logical inference can we deduce from those two conclusions. So in order to solve this question, let's have a look at useful data. So in such type of questions that involves some statements and their corresponding conclusions, we need to draw the Venn diagram to interpret the conclusions and try to find a scenario to contradict the conclusions. If you can't find one, we mark our answer based on our deductions. So let's use this concept and try to solve the problem. So the two statements given to us are all bacteria are microorganisms and all pathogens are microorganisms. So let's try to represent these statements in a Venn diagram. So we have a bigger set of microorganisms, and within this set there is a subset of bacteria and pathogens. Now let's have a look at the conclusions. The conclusion 1 states that some pathogens are bacteria. So let's take a case 1 and try to find a counter example of this conclusion. So the conclusion is some pathogens are bacteria. So if I draw the sets in such a way like this, then there would be a disjoint set between bacteria and pathogens, that is, the intersection of bacteria and pathogens would be phi, which also says that some pathogens are bacteria is not true in this case. So in this case, conclusion 1 is false. Now let's have a look at conclusion 2. Conclusion 2 states that all pathogens are not bacteria. So in this case, conclusion 2 is true, because from the Venn diagram I can see that all pathogens are not bacteria, which is true. Now let's try to build another case. So in this case, if I take a common set between bacteria and pathogen, then conclusion 1 states that some pathogens are bacteria, which is true, because there would be at least one pathogen which is bacteria. And since conclusion 1 is true, conclusion 2 would automatically become false, because conclusion 2 states that all pathogens are not bacteria. And if even one pathogen is a bacteria, then that means that conclusion 2 would automatically become false. So in this case, conclusion 1 is true and conclusion 2 is false. Let's try to see a third case. Now in this case, if I keep all the bacteria within the pathogen, then I would have my Venn diagram something like this. So here, if I go for conclusion 1, then this would be true, because some pathogens are bacteria, and conclusion 2 would be false, because all pathogens are not bacteria, which is false. Now if I look at the last possible case that can be formed, which is the reverse of case 3, in which the bacteria lies outside the pathogens, or the pathogens is contained within bacteria, I would have my Venn diagram something like this. Now in this case, conclusion 1 would be true, because some pathogens are bacteria, and conclusion 2 would be false, because all pathogens are not bacteria. Here all pathogens are bacteria. So here conclusion 1 would be true and conclusion 2 would be false. Now let's look at the options given to us. Option A states that only conclusion 1 is correct, but I have proved and I have shown a counter example where conclusion 1 is false. So option A within itself is incorrect. Similarly, option B states that only conclusion 2 is correct, and I have shown a counter example in which conclusion 2 is false. So option B is also incorrect. Now since option A and option B is incorrect, I can say that option D would be the correct answer, because neither conclusion 1 nor conclusion 2 is correct, and I have proved the cases in which neither of these two conditions within itself is true. Now let's look at the third case, which states that either conclusion 1 or conclusion 2 is correct. Now this statement seems to be correct. Let's see how. If I look at all the cases, I can say that either of these two conditions is definitely true. In all the possible cases, either conclusion 1 is true or conclusion 2 is true. So in all the four cases, either of these two conditions is definitely true. So I can say that option C is also the right answer. Now, in the final answer key, option D was given as the right answer, but later option C was also considered to be the right answer. So the right answer for this question is option C and D. Thank you.